Joining me is former Navy Chaplain Gordon Klingenschmidt. The last time that the chaplain joined us, he made the case that, unlike me, he did not believe that we were now seeing a tide that could not be turned back in terms of gay marriage legislation, marriage equality legislation, although I made the case that we would continue to see more and more states legalize full marriage equality. Now, in the 2012 election, which just took place, we had Maryland, Maine, and Washington, by a popular vote, for the first time by a popular vote, vote to make marriage equality the law of the land. So I guess I will open it up there. Chaplain, your thoughts?
Well, I think this confirms something that Jesus said in Matthew 7, that broad is the road that leads to destruction, and many enter into it, but narrow is the road that leads to eternal life, and only a few find it. So I wouldn't be surprised if most people in America voted against God and against God's values if that wasn't a confirmation of something that Jesus predicted would come in the end times, that there would be a massive rebellion against God, that people would turn to Satan, that people would have all kinds of sin and embrace sin as the law of the land. I'm not surprised that this is happening eventually. I'm just saddened that it's happening so soon to America.
And do you believe that this is going to lead, as you said, you referenced the end times? Are we looking here at popular votes for gay marriage leading to the destruction of the planet?
Well, I didn't say that, but it does say in Romans 1, verse 32, knowing the judgment of God, that those who commit such things, homosexual acts, for example, are not only worthy of death, not only for those who do them, but for those who have pleasure in those who do them. So not only does the Bible say that homosexuality is a sin that will lead to the destruction of those who partake in it, it ultimately also condemns the people who lend their voice of approval to that kind of sinful lifestyle.
So, well, I want to get to those people, in other words, the voters, in a second. But since you brought up those acts and those things which you referred to as homosexuality, doesn't the Bible refer to, for example, eating shellfish or cutting a man cutting his hair very short or women cutting their hair very short in the same context as homosexuality? Even, in other words, the passage you just read from Romans 23 or whatever it was. Wouldn't that apply also to people eating? Is someone eating shrimp contributing in the same amount, more or less, to the destruction of this planet as someone who may be gay?
You know, that's a common fallacy that homosexuals try to make in their biblical argument, that Old Testament prohibitions against unkosher food somehow apply to New Testament Gentile Christians. We know very specifically in the Bible, in Acts chapter 15, the New Testament church had a council that said and decided, because they heard from God, that all the Old Testament rules do not apply to New Testament Christians, except for four rules. You're not supposed to drink blood. You're not supposed to eat food that was strangled to idols. There's another one. And then you're not supposed to engage in sexual immorality.
Ah, so very conveniently.
In there, gotcha. Shellfish are not prohibited. In fact, Peter, in Acts chapter 10, he saw a vision and he ate pork for the first time. So eating pork was not even forbidden for a Jewish Christian like the Apostle Peter. That's a false argument. But
right.
Sexual immorality is always prohibited, even in the New Testament. And it's not the same as the Old Testament that we're not under anymore.
Okay, good. So very convenient. We have conveniently eliminated all the old restrictions except for the one about gay marriage. Very, very clever. So I like that. That's interesting stuff. Let's go back to those people, though, Chaplain, because this is the first time that by popular vote we have now furthered marriage equality. What is your thought about what happened to those people? In other words, have they been infected by Satan, as you have previously implied on the show? Would they benefit from an exorcism, as you have implied on the show before, that you're able to do with a 50% success rate? I mean, in other words, what happened to the voters? Why did they do this?
Well, David, this might be a good time to mention the book I just published about 2 months ago. I'll send you a free copy of it. It's called The Demons of Barack H. Obama: How the Gift of Discerning of Spirits Helps Us Understand What's Happening in American Politics. So I'll offer that to you if you want to send me your address. But to blame the voters, I wouldn't say that. Elections, I served in the military. I defend the Constitution. I defend democracy. I think elections in general are a good idea, but they are no indicator of right and wrong in society.
So let me stop right there. Let me stop you right there just for 1 second. Yeah. I find it funny when like for example, during a debate, Mitt Romney said something along the lines of, I love teachers, but, and that's never a good a way to start a sentence. You just started with, I'm in favor of having elections about things, but. We're not off to a good start, are we, Chaplain?
Well, the only distinction that you're missing here, and you forgot the second half of my sentence, is that they're not an indication of godly morality. In the Bible, the only time that an election was held in the New Testament was the time they took a vote to crucify Jesus Christ and release Barnabas instead of Jesus. Hmm. So elections don't always go the way that God wants them to go.
Interesting.
God is the ultimate arbiter of morality, and God will be the final judge of America. And in states like Maryland and Washington, and even where I live in Colorado, they want this marijuana initiative now.
That's ungodly as well. I assume you're against that.
Well, I think I am. I think the Bible wants what's in the best interest of the health and well-being, spirit, soul, and body of all of the people. And if the people want to vote destruction unto themselves or the ability to destroy their own bodies with AIDS or with drugs or with, you know, sexually transmitted diseases, or simply to destroy their own soul with demonic possession,
yeah,
I think they can vote for that. They can vote to crucify Jesus in a sense. But at the same time, I saw a silver lining in the elections. Christian conservatives had many, many victories that were not reported by the mainstream media, and I can address those if you want.
Well, let's put that aside for a second. You mentioned before that the election may not have gone the way that God had intended. Isn't it the height of arrogance and pomposity to think that God is involved in the minutiae of electoral politics in one country, on one planet of the entire universe that he created, right? I mean, isn't that the height of arrogance, Chaplain?
No, I think it's a sign that God loves us so dearly that he knows and counts the number of hairs on our head. If a sparrow cannot fall from the sky without God's notice, how can a nation rise to prominence without God's blessing? That was what our founding fathers prayed before they signed the first Constitution. So
All right.
I'm concerned that President Obama, for example, has become a Pied Piper of the vote in Maryland. Did you realize, and I saw some exit polling, that the African-American community just 4 years ago in California rejected homosexual marriage by 75%.
Right, Proposition 8.
Now in Maryland, I see the African-American community has approved homosexual marriage in exit polling by about 51%. So why the sudden change?
Well, I would argue, Chaplain, you're asking me the question, so I would answer it. I believe African-Americans, since that vote, have actually been touched by God, and they have been enlightened such that now they realize discrimination is wrong, equality is right, and they have voted in the way that God would have wanted, that Jesus would have wanted. And as a Jewish man, it's incredible for me to be saying this, but I believe that they voted for Jesus by voting that way in Maryland.
That's an interesting theory, but you're failing to discern the spirits behind that. You're confusing the Holy Spirit with the demonic spirit that's emphasizing that. My African-American friends that I have supported, candidates like Alan Keyes for president,
of course,
or E.W. Jackson, who ran for Senate in Virginia, they've come out and said, this is an abomination. And
right.
In fact, it's an insult to the black community to say that homosexual equality is somehow equal to racial equality, because the two have nothing to do with each other. One you're born with, and the other sin you choose.
No, you're born with both. Yeah, we've widely documented
sin
that.
With equality.
You're born with both, yeah.
People will never have a right to choose sin, because sin is never equal to holiness in the eyes of God.
Right. Well, nobody chooses to be gay. Nobody chooses to be black. You're making a very good point. Last thing, and we're very low on time here, Chaplain.
The opposite of that.
We're very low on time, so I just want to get your quick thought. And be honest with me, please. I know that the right-wing conservative anti-gay crowd often votes Republican rather than Democrat. But out of curiosity, do they care on fiscal policy? Do the right-wing anti-gay individuals, do they really care about, for example, Mitt Romney's fiscal policy, or are these really votes on social issues?
I think the church will always vote on social issues. You saw, for example, in New York State, Christian conservatives fired 5 of the 7 Republicans who forced homosexual marriage on the New York State voters against their will.
Right.
So these were fiscal conservatives, but they were social liberals, pro-homosexual Republicans, and 5 out of 7 were voted out of office and fired by the New York State voters. So the church is rising up, even in blue states. We're never going to lay down our right to vote. We're going to fully participate. We're going to legislate our views just the same way that you and your community would legislate your views. And,
all right.
May the best man win, but in the end, God is going to judge and God will decide who the real victor is.
Well, no, in the end, the same thing that's happening is going to keep happening, which is every time you and I have these interviews, about every 6 or 8 months, more states have legalized gay marriage. And I think that's what's going to continue to happen. But hey, maybe it'll lead to the destruction of this universe, as you have mentioned, Chaplain. We've been speaking with former Navy Chaplain Gordon Klingenschmitt. The new book is, hold it up, Chaplain, I believe it's The Demons of Barack H. Obama. The Demons of Barack H. Obama. There it is.
Available on Amazon and our website, which is prayinjesusname.org.
All right. Very good. People have the website. Thank you, as always, Chaplain, for joining us today.
Okay. Bye-bye.